Whoa, by the stars, my poor heart. I just about pissed my jumpsuit. Most people don't.
We're used to folks swooning at our feet. You don't gotta be embarrassed.
A healthy survival reflex is nothing to be embarrassed about. Besides, this place is enough to try anyone's nerves. Where should I begin? With the oversized mantisaurs? Or perhaps the rat spewing acid at our walls? The board was right. This place isn't fit for human habitation, and I was a fool for staying. That was a real popular meal 10-20 years back, before the board tucked tail and ran. These days, everybody's had a belly full of salt tuna. They all want borscht, and the mushrooms, well, not many venture out of town, what with the monsters hereabouts. I can whip one up for you, but it'll cost. Here's a menu. You got it. I got all the ingredients. Should only take about an hour in the oven. There we are. Now, if you don't mind, I really need to take a leak.
A reminder to all crew members, there is only one toilet on the ship.
The dustback casserole Mr. Raymond made smells incredible. Oh, I kind of want to take a little taste, but I'm gonna be strong. Now look how cute these cakes from Cascadia are. Someone even traced little hearts in them. I guess that settles dinner. Thanks for hauling me all over creation, Captain. If there's leftovers, they're all yours. I got this nice meal all planned out with music, and I got that soap to scrub up with, but I don't got nothing nice to wear, Captain. I don't have a head for fashion, and I can't really picture myself in something clean and pretty. There's this place I heard of in Byzantium, Jolliker's Haberdashery. I bet I could find something nigh on perfect at a place like that. Thanks, Captain. I know I've been asking a lot, but you help me out every time. You're the best.
Greetings, and welcome to Monarch Stellar Industries, producers and purveyors of the finest salt tuna and halcyon. What can I do for you today? You know, sending you is the first bright idea I've seen from that man, because I told him to stop bothering me about it a week ago. I still don't know anything about it, but if you want to help him, Velma's the one to ask. She's in the warehouse. But I'll warn you, Grim wore her patience thin a long time ago. Not at all. Mr. Nandi treats us all right and pays us well. I just spent most of my paycheck on Raptodon acid. Laws, no. Sometimes it's canid teeth, or mantis worm wings. Whatever Sebastian has in stock, really. So I can talk to him, of course. He doesn't get going about much else. Sort of the strong, silent type. Unfortunately, my apartment's kind of filling up with his stuff. And some of the neighbors are complaining about the smell. I couldn't. What if he says no? Hey, maybe you could ask him for me. I mean, a no would still be bad, but it won't be quite as embarrassing if you ask. Oh, Mr. Nandi's doing that thing where he breathes through his nose real slowly. I'd better get back to work. He doesn't talk much, but he's got this quiet intensity, you know? Like there's stuff going on inside his head that you have no idea about. Plus, he's got great legs. It's hard to find a man who doesn't skimp on lower body exercises.
Good to have standards, I guess.
I know what I'm looking for. Sorry. Sometimes I get carried away.
Smells like rat in here.
Oh, it does work. I bought some musk from
Hey, Velma, I got...
Look, you can tell Catherine the new shipment will be ready when it's ready, all right? She's welcome to come up here and pack boxes herself if she's in such a hurry. Did she now? Well, I can see I was mistaken. Because if Catherine really had sent you, there'd be a lot more expletives in your message. Hope you can forgive my temper. This job has been running me ragged lately. First, my autoloader foreman stages a walkout, and now my chief pescatological health manager is missing. This again? I swear, this is the last time I contract for any special requests. You can tell Grim his poster came in. You can also tell him I got a better offer for it. So now it's going to Nell. That about cover it? She runs the betting parlor across the way. Nice professional lady. She asked me about the poster once. Just once. Made a real generous offer, too. Damn right it is. It's staying locked up in my office until Nell shows with her money. No. I paid Sublight for it, so it's mine. And when Nell pays me for it, it'll be hers. Grim may have asked for the poster, but it's not his until I take his money. Fine by me. That he's got his load on and I'm stuck covering his shift? That's... wow. I sure feel like an ass now. Yeah, I wouldn't wish that on Catherine herself. Still, it's good to know what happened to him. And that I ought to start looking for a replacement. Something else on your mind?
All the rest.
Against regulations!
What do you think you're doing?
I don't have time for this.
Have you had time to check on that poster yet? I keep wondering if it's come in. Would you look at that? The Rizzo's logo is nice and bright, and you can still smell the ink on Mr. Holcomb's signature. I can't thank you enough. Still, you can have the bits I was gonna spend at the bar this week. And you know what? Take my old toss ball blocker too. Never get the chance to use it these days.
What's up, boss?
real flick.
Thank you. The gunship. Have you secured its targeting module? Mount its guns to our walls or the walls of Stellar Bay. The board is coming, Captain, and these weapons will defend us from their blasphemies. Why wouldn't they? As we speak, our message assaults their populace through their favorite entertainment mediums. Surely their retaliation will come soon.
If the Iconoclasts reach that ship first, there won't be any chance for a peaceful monarch.
I don't suppose you've found the targeting module yet. I've sent patrols, but they're running into trouble with the Iconoclasts. Well, because the module controls the weapons systems. Because once we mount them on Stellar Bay's walls, no Marauder or Raptodon will ever be a threat to us again.
Gotta hand it to you, Sanjar. That ain't a bad plan.
It's absolutely foolproof. Stellar Bay will be as secure as any other settlement in Halcyon. The boards on Salvage and Recovery Clause 32B would say differently.
And they won't dare challenge us over this. Not after the data you found on their experiments here.
Look, Celia, he's being funny again.
I don't think so, sir.
Really? Well, I could have sworn... Well, that's not important. What is important is that there's a considerable distance between us and that ship, and most of it is inhabited by Marauders and Raptodons. Oh, it is. And that's not saying anything about the Sulphur Pits, the Mantisaurs, the Iconoclast Rebels, Celia, do we have any pep pills? I'm feeling lightheaded.
I'm afraid you finished them going over the sales reports last week.
Oh, well, I suppose you see our predicament.
you imagine what those maniacs would do with weapons like that? They'd wreak havoc.
You said that like it's a problem.
The board would consider us complicit in any of their folly. That would only get us ousted again.
And roll back all the progress we've made at reconciling with the rest of Halcyon.
Oh, I've known their ilk long enough. Even if they merely sat on the scraps, the threat of a bunch of anarchists holding a gunship would bring the full wrath of the board down on Monarch. We can't afford that. Good, because we haven't a moment to lose. They're all mad! And what's more, they left us! I don't see any way for us to work together. Ugh, not this again.
Remember what we practiced, sir?
Yes. The words in those reviews were very hurtful, but they do not define me. I am a mantipillar, and my will is my cocoon. I can emerge and become whatever I wish. Normally, I'd find this kind of talk from you quite invigorating. But this is a difficult moment for me. Still, perhaps you have a point. Supposing you're right, who exactly would you have me work with? The iconoclasts are not the most compromising sorts. That's an interesting suggestion. I confess I don't know much about her except that she worked for Rizzo. I'd be willing to consider it, but I need to see her review first. Very well. I can't promise anything, but let's see what we have here. Well, it seems like she's actually very qualified. I wasn't expecting to say this, but if you can put her in charge and convince her to agree to a meeting, I'd be willing to discuss terms.
Welcome back. You find anything out there?